Hey friends, and welcome back. So guys, I am here to share my Walgreens couponing haul with you, taking advantage of the beauty perk that we have, which is spend 25 on beauty products and you get 7,000 points back, which is $7. Now I received this perk in my app as a digital coupon. Not everyone will receive this coupon, no rhyme or reason as to why. It is just one of those Walgreens mysteries. Not everybody gets these coupons, have no clue as to why. In fact, I only received this coupon on one of my accounts, which is my main account. And by main, I just mean the account that I'm most active on throughout the month. So it is just one of those things. Now, I also found it in the paper form at one of my stores as well. So the digital coupon and the paper coupon will stack together, giving you back 4,000 points for spending just $25. Do note, these coupons are not meant to stack. However, 9 times out of 10, they will. They have been forever in a day, for as long as I can remember. But nonetheless, they're not meant to stack, but they do. So not every store will receive the paper coupon. In my experience and in my location, typically the stores that have an actual beauty consultant is the ones that get these coupons here. And by beauty consultant, I mean someone that is actually, I guess, trained to apply makeup, help people match foundations and all that stuff there. An actual consultant, not just a beauty counter. So keep that in mind. Again, I found this at a location that has an actual beauty consultant, not just the beauty counter. And again, those are not meant to stack, but they do. So it is what it is. All right. Now I did just one deal, one transaction, utilizing those $10 register rewards and or coupons that we received a couple weeks back for, say, $10 on any Elmay or Revlon product. So I wanted to go ahead and use those to take advantage of being able to get back the 14,000 in points, again, stacking the digital coupon as well as the paper coupon. What else do I need to tell you for the details of this haul video? Oh, the items I'm picking up is makeup items. So cosmetics, I think for the entire month, is buy two and you get one for free. At Walgreens, anytime you get something that is buy X and get X free, the free item will automatically ring up for zero. So you cannot count those towards your threshold purchase if you do in fact have a threshold purchase that you have to make. In this case, $25 is what we have to spend in beauty products in order to get the 7,000 points back. So again, when it's a buy one, get one free, or buy two, get one free, whatever the case is, the free item at Walgreens will always ring up at zero. So you do not want to count that amount in to your threshold amount. And I think that's pretty much it. So I'll turn the camera around, show you guys what I picked up, go over the receipt, and then go over details and everything. And that'll be that. As always, if you have questions about anything, leave it in the comments for me. I don't mind answering. I will throw in any quick tips that I need to in a pinned comment. So definitely check there, because your question may just have been answered there. And even, guys, even if your question has been answered there, drop some type of comment in the video. Drop some type of comment in the comment section, because it does help the performance of the video. It tells YouTube that people are interested in this video, interested in this content. So YouTube will continue to promote the video and the channel. So again, even if I answer your question directly, verbally, or if I answer it with a comment, a pinned comment, still drop something in the comment section. Even if it's just, great haul, thanks for sharing, have a nice day, I have a blue shirt on today, whatever, I don't care. I'm just saying it helps the performance of the video, and it helps YouTube to recognize that this content, people are interested in it, and they will promote it, so on and so forth. And that is true across any videos that you are watching, any content creator that you are watching, dropping any sort of comment in the comment section, liking the video and sharing the video, and of course allowing the video to play all the way through, helps the video perform better and helps the channel overall. Okay, enough pitching the YouTube background stuff. Let's go ahead and get into also, guys, before I forget, there's a promotion going on Elmay as well as Revlon Cosmetics. When you spend $15, you're supposed to get a $5 register reward back. Well, I spent well over $15 today. I did not get that register reward back, and I know that the Catalina machine is working because I did get back the little 20% off a $10 purchase of something Catalina. So I know the machine was working, but I didn't get it back. Don't know why. My theory is because I used one of those Catalinas that were printing out a couple weeks ago for $10 off any Revlon or Elme product, that maybe that's why. And now that I think about it, last week I believe Elme was on sale and Revlon, and I know I picked some up and I spent over $15 and I did not get that $5 register reward, and I did use the $10 coupon of those. So I don't know. I'm just letting you know that there is a promotion. I'll throw a pic of the tag that's in my store on the screen for you. So if you happen to do this same deal, or you pick up $15 in Revlon Cosmetics or Elme, you don't get your $5 register reward back. If your store is tagged, let your cashier know and or manager. They may issue you the points, or they may direct you to call the Catalina company or contact them, and they may end up sending you an actual Catalina register reward in the mail. So long story short, it didn't dawn on me until after the fact. Like, I done checked out, got in the truck, and set the red light. And I was like, darn it. So I'm going to contact the Catalina company and see what comes of it. And I'll come back and update you guys on that once I do. I don't know. You're supposed to get $5 register reward if you spend $15 or more in Elme or Revlon products. I did not receive that reward today. And I did not receive that reward the last time I did it either. And my thought is because I used this $10 coupon that was printing out couple weeks ago. So I don't know, but anyways, enough yapping. Let's get into the receipt and the breakdown of everything.
All right, guys, so here's my huge Walgreens haul. I picked up 6 of those Elme lipsticks. Remember, they're on sale, buy 2 get 1 for free, so the free items will rank up at 0 automatically, so you do not want to count them towards your threshold purchase. So for 4 of them, it came out to a total of $31.96. I used 2 of the $10 off any Revlon or Elme cosmetic, and then I used the $6 register reward that I had from this week's P&G deal, left my total at $5.96. I rolled 5,000 points and paid 96 cents cash out of pocket. So remember, with Walgreens manufacturer coupons, register rewards, Catalinas like so, are considered currency, and that's how they're applied in the system. So I had 2 of the $10 coupons, so 10 and 10, that's 20. Just for example's sake, and to give you guys a visual, this is my $6 register reward. Obviously, it is not a register reward, but I don't have it because, well, I used it. So 6 plus 20 is $26. So I spent $26, which surpasses my threshold of 25. Remember, I must spend 25 in order to get the 7,000 points. $26 here surpassed that. So my remaining balance after my coupons were applied was $5.96, and that's how come I was able to roll in 5,000 points and then only paying 96 cents plus tax cash out of my pocket. Y'all, I write like an infant, a hot mess, but hopefully you guys can make this out. I will also type out a quick overview of this in a pinned comment for you. $26 in currency, it meets my spend threshold of 25. So points can be used for the remaining balance, and that's exactly what I did. So let's look at the receipt. Elme, $7.99, zero for the free item. Same thing going down. There is my point coupon that was digital for spend 25, get 7,000 points. My 2 $10 Catalina coupons, and then my $6 register reward from the P&G deal. Subtotal, $5.96. With tax, $6.45. So I was able to redeem 5,000 points, and I paid the difference cash out of pocket. A total of $26 qualified towards beauty. Mister, can you? I don't know what you're doing over there, but can you stop moving the table?
Oh, I was talking about going go knock on the door.
Go knock on the door for what, Mason?
Tell them to, well, I'm trying to tell them.
What are you trying to tell them, Mason?
So can I please close their application?
Close the application. Okay, go ahead, Mason. Hashtag mom life. My son just got home from school, and instead of doing homework, he's on the game. And instead of being a responsible parent, I'm making a YouTube video. Moving on. Okay, so as you see, my bonus points was 14,000. I got 7,000 for the digital booster and then 7,000 for the paper. So they did stack. And you see, I redeemed 5,000 points. So I hope that was clear. Let's go back over the receipt one more time. I hope that all made sense and it was clear. I had no additional coupons for Almay outside of the $10 coupons. These here and then my retro rewards. So again, since only I'm buying six items and I only had three coupons that I'm using, I did not need to get a filler or anything like that for the register rewards because, again, I'm buying six items and I only have three coupons. I hope that made sense. Let's go back over to the written out breakdown. That way you guys can see. And that is that. So what I did in store is my subtotal was $31.96. I went ahead and subtracted my coupons and I was like, okay, I have $26. What does that leave me? So I wanted to make sure I would be able to use the 5,000 points. So simple math, $31.96 minus the amount I'm wanting to use in points, making sure that after I use points, I was still at my threshold amount, which is the $25. And then my currency applied. So just think of this as backwards. $31.96 minus the 5,000 points. That would have left me at $26.96, and I had $26 in currency. Let me write that out right quick. Okay, so there we go. Hopefully this makes sense as well. The math is the same. It's just a matter of how I got there, I guess, if you will. So again, $31.96 with my subtotal minus the amount I wanted to roll in points, and then minus my currency, which was my coupons, left me at 96 cents. So I was able to use points on a spend deal. All right, guys, so that is all I have for you. Again, if you have questions about anything, check the pinned comments. Your question may have been answered there. If not, leave it in the comment section for me. And even if it has been answered, definitely leave a comment. Again, it does help the video and it definitely helps the channel as well. As always, I appreciate each and every one of you for watching my videos, for sharing my videos, and all that stuff there. As always, be sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe if you have not done so already. And until next time, guys, happy couponing.